Excuse me, miss. You have the time?
Yes, it's Niles.
Yeah, man.
You look... Did you get hit on the head by a coconut?
The coconut of revelation. I discovered a whole new side of myself in Belize, and I'm not going to abandon Island Niles just because my vacation's over.
Well, Island Niles might want to rethink the short pants.
Island Niles would prefer not to wear pants at all. You should have seen us, Roz. Out in the elements, nothing on our bodies but sunblock 120. It's exhilarating and primal, and frankly, it's disappointing to have to strap myself back into these fabric shackles.
So you're going to be spending all your time at the nude beach now?
Seattle has a nude beach?
Well, not officially, but just south of Alki, there's this little strip near the lighthouse.
Thanks for the tip, Roz.
Here's another one. Don't go on Thursdays. It's senior volleyball day.
Oh, well, Roz, I see you've met Island Niles. At least he did you the courtesy of putting a shirt on.
I'm still not wearing underpants. Afternoon, Daphne. Dad?
Niles?
What happened to my noble savage?
I'll tell you what happened. Roz told me about this wonderful nude beach. So I went down there this morning to check it out for us. It was so peaceful, I decided to do my sunrise Tai Chi, have my naked body caressed by the rosy fingers of the new dawn, you know.
Oh, jeez.
Well, I left my clothing and my cares in the car, walked down to the beach, and settled in for my first exercise, grasping the bird's tail. Just at that moment, the sun peeked over the mountaintops, illuminating not only my splendid nakedness, but the bus for the Christian Women's Society.
They went to a nude beach?
No, and neither did I. The next few minutes are a blur as I zigzag my way back to the car, being pelted with driftwood and Bibles. Needless to say, Island Niles died on that beach.
Oh, honey. Will he ever be back?
Maybe at Christmas.
Hello. Oh, Niles, welcome back.